Hello, welcome to Asia Business Report. I'm Sherry Jitnail in Singapore. Asia's largest commodities trader, Noble Group, is poised to post its first full-year loss in nearly two decades. Now, blaming collapsing coal prices, the company issued a profit warning earlier this week, saying it's expecting a write-down of $1.2 billion. The Noble share price has plummeted 70% in the last year. So what are its prospects now? For more, I'm joined now by the Director of Research for Religare Capital Markets, Nirgunan Tiruchelvam, who joins me now in the studio. Now, Nirgunan, we know that this is an over $1 billion write-down. How much of a concern is this alongside what's expected to be dismal results?
Well, we need to look at it in the context of what commodity traders are. Commodity traders such as Noble are the lubricants in the world of commodities. They match buyers and sellers, playing the role of intermediaries. And in doing so, they take on a tremendous degree of risk. Many of them are carrying a large degree of inventory on their books, and this makes them vulnerable to the ups and downs of commodity prices, and that's precisely what Noble is facing at this point.
Indeed, and as you say, commodity traders, we've seen the likes of Olam as well having to deal with the same. Now, however, Noble was accused of various things last year, controversial accounting scandal, overinflating its assets. So how much of this slide in its fortune can be blamed on that?
Well, the stock has actually fallen very sharply in value over the last year. We need to focus on the company's cash flow generation. This is a factor we need to look at for a number of companies, not just Noble. Many of the companies in this industry need to generate cash to generate confidence from the investors. And it's that factor that we need to focus on very intensely as they announce results this evening.
Now, you talk about the share price, a huge fall in the last year, some 70% of its value loss, and part of this as it also became a target for short sellers. So how much do you think the share price will ever recover from this?
When a company has fallen to 30% of its book value, it is often the case that investors can see value. Rather, we can see a long-term perspective in this company where the company presents an excellent investment opportunities for those who are looking for deep value investments.
Right. Now, interesting. You talked earlier about generating cash. I mean, how is the company going to do this with all the problems it's had? And also, if you factor in the fact that we've got climate change talks saying that we need to move away from coal-fueled power generation, and this is something that Noble does a lot of. Briefly, what do you see this company heading for, and what's its future?
Well, the aversion towards fossil fuels has much more resonance when prices are at an elevated level. When they have depressed, it's very difficult for people to look for cheaper, cleaner alternatives. So the clean energy lobby would be under pressure in this price environment.
All right, we'll leave it there. We're running out of time. Nirgunan Tiruchelvam there. Thanks for joining us.